My name is Samora Okujeni. I'm a member of the Bernstein Center Freiburg. I did my PhD here in 2013, and I've since then continued to work as a postdoc in the lab of Ulrich Egert. As experimental neurobiologists, we are of course interested in the functioning of the brain. The brain is a highly complex organ with billions of neurons, and each of them having thousands of synapses. So it's quite a challenge to understand the processes and the functioning of the system. So in order to gain more insight into this, we take a subset of neurons which we extract from the brain and seed them onto, well, petri dishes basically. When you seed neurons onto a petri dish, these neurons immediately start to grow out neurites and to migrate. And lastly, a network structure forms, which is clearly not random, but you have local clusters of neurons, you have neurite bundles extending between these clusters. And interestingly, this kind of network organization is ubiquitously found in neuronal networks. So it's similar to a telecommunication system where you have highly connected local communities and long-range landlines. And we are interested in understanding why neurons do what they do and what governs kind of this self-organization process. In order to study dependencies between network structure and network activity, we need to record neurons, and we currently pursue different approaches. On the one hand, we can make extracellular recordings with microelectrode arrays on which these networks grow. And we currently can record from up to 1,000 neurons with microelectrode arrays. And we also pursue calcium imaging, which allows us to monitor many cells in a local area of the network. Apart from that, we also do combined patch clamp recordings, which gives us insight into kind of intracellular signals. Yeah, so interestingly, you find a lot of similarities between networks in culture and networks in the brain. The reason may be because you have similar rules of interaction between neurons. So neurons don't differentiate themselves intrinsically based on an intrinsic program, but they communicate with each other, and the processes are basically preserved in culture. So interfering with these processes actually leads to completely different organization, structural organization. So when you manipulate the neuronal differentiation process, you can have more homogeneous networks, for instance, where you have less clustering, or you can have more clustered networks. So it seems that these processes are calibrated to establish some degree of clustering in a network, which supposedly is the most efficient organization for the functional purpose. So this is one of our research goals or topics, or which influence does the network structure have on the functioning of a network?
So we think that if architecture which is built serves a certain purpose. So what we find is that networks with a certain degree of clustering are more spontaneously active, for instance, and spontaneous activity is important for information processing. With our networks, we can test predictions from theory, and also found that several of these predictions which have been made, for instance, that clustered networks are optimal in sustaining activity, are also optimal in terms of producing a certain richness of activity patterns, that this is actually also the case in cultured networks. And I think that this may play an important role in information processing as such in the brain. In a wide range of neural diseases, you find that this is associated with changes in the connectivity. You have sprouting of neurites, for instance, in epilepsy, or after brain injuries, which can lead to epilepsy. These changes in the connectivity directly affect, of course, the dynamics of the network. So I think understanding how a certain connectivity affects the dynamics of a network is essential to also understand how a certain change in the connectivity may drive such pathologic dynamics. I think that with our work, we kind of provide one piece to the puzzle of better understanding how the brain works.